Many congratulations with this film. I mean, it really is a very sort of touching, moving story, isn't it?
Have you seen it?
I have indeed.
You have, yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, good. Did you cry?
I did. Yeah, I really
lump in the throat. Yeah, no, I was just saying it's one of those films that, you know, who knows how much longer we'll be making films like this for the cinema, with the like of, you know, Netflix and Amazon and Apple and so on really taking over. I'm hoping that we're not the last wave, that these sorts of films will keep on getting financed for the big screen, and that the audience, like me, will tire of all those films with man in the title, Superman, Spider-Man, Batman, so on and so on and so on. Well, Woman would be actually a nice change. I think it's becoming a bit of a ghetto, isn't it, cinema now, for just big visual effects extravaganzas. And I hope that there's room for good stories well told.
And that are character-driven, which this very much is, isn't it, really?
Yes. I mean, it's hard to argue against Netflix making long series of character-driven stories, because we always used to say, you know, fitting it into 90 minutes is quite hard. You know, if only we had 5 hours. Well, now that is possible. So that I don't disapprove of, obviously. How can you? But I do think big screen experiences should not be restricted to sequels and as superhero films.
And talking of experiences, one of the wonderful things that we experience through this film, and what disarms us in this film, is the routine that we see Judge Fiona going through, the walking to work, and you're actually filming in the Royal Court of Justice. Can you tell us more about the logistics of actually being able to do that?
Well, we had a consultant, a friend of Ian's, in fact, the man who, as a judge, judged some of the stories that really inspired Ian to write the novel in the first place, Sir Alan Ward. And Sir Alan is so respected, and he's retired now, but so loved by the legal world, I was going to say industry, he was our passepartout. He introduced us to the under treasurer, who is the sort of CEO of Gray's Inn, they sort of gave us carte blanche to film Gray's Inn. Sir Alan then took us to meet the Lord Chief Justice, and the Lord Chief Justice said, yes, you can film in the Royal Courts, which is something that, you know, is actually forbidden at the moment.
Say, especially in this precarious time,
yeah,
that we're,
yeah,
in at the moment. Also see the more contemporary side of the Royal Court of Justice as well, don't we?
Well, we see the family division, which is something that is not usually seen in TV dramas. In TV dramas, we're used to the criminal courts, but it is nice to see something in the family division, which, as Ian said, is sort of the stories, the pain, you know, it's all family related, and it's sort of like the stuff of the 19th century novel. It's very different from the usual TV fare.